On this edition of One Championship Weekly, it was a night to remember in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Hometown hero Agilan Thani faced Zebaztian Kadestam in a pivotal welterweight clash at the top of a stacked card at One Pursuit of Power. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Zebaztian Kadestam made his return following a 10-month break from competition. The Swedish striker faced Malaysian superhero Agilan Thani in the main event. It was a captivating three-round battle, and both athletes had their moments in what was a closely competitive affair. We join this bout in round three.
Third and final round. In front of a massive crowd inside the Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. It's One Championship Pursuit of Power. Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, live on the One Super App. Hope you're enjoying the martial arts action. And an aggressive start here from Kadestam.
After the hug, he fires a 1-2 right down the pipe.
Kadestam looks aggressive coming forward early in this final stanza. Jab 2 there from the Swede. Thani forced to move, use a lot of the cage.
And both these guys are in a war of attrition, but this is the best we've seen both these guys look, Michael. They're both sharp and crisp. And look at their conditioning. It's great. Getting into the third round now, and these guys still look just like they did in the first.
The striking volume, the turning heel kick to the liver again of Agilan Thani. The high kick from Kadestam.
Oh, Kadestam's starting to turn it on.
These two men haven't slowed. They've got the tempo. They've got the volume here in the third round. And knee. Thani wants it to get hold of the low single. Southpaw starts, throws the left hand at the power side. Kadestam backs him up behind him. Thani drifts back to center cut.
Wow, Kadestam is starting to light Thani up. Tani's got to get a takedown. Bait him in, shoot him for that double leg.
Kadestam controlling center cage. Thani backed against the wire. Downward elbow, hoping to go for the collarbone. Thrust out the jab as the bandit. Tani's going to go there. He's going to do something here. Here the crowd trying to rally, trying to spur on and encourage Agilan Thani to dig deep into the well of guts and intestinal fortitude. Left hook from Kadestam, and Thani tries for a long single. Kadestam gets airborne. Zebaztian Kadestam owning Agilan Thani in the stand-up. The downward elbow, the crossing elbow. It's all Thani. It's good night, Irene. Thani taking the nose of Zebaztian Kadestam, and Kadestam a superior striking display.
Kadestam shifted into an entirely new level we have not seen before. Took to the air, landed a big flying knee. And look at this, hands down by his waist and just lets it go. Look at that beautiful spinning back kick. Goes upstairs this time. The swagger was on point. The hands were accurate. Zebaztian Kadestam, what a match, and a big left hook to finish the show.
And now, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 56 seconds in the third and final round. For your winner, by way of TKO, Zebaztian Kadestam!
Zebaztian Kadestam victorious over Agilan Thani. Absolutely ferocious striking in the third and final round to send Thani down. What a moment for Kadestam. He really did turn it up to another level in that third stanza.
When we return, Muay Thai world champions Joe Nadawat and Johan Dre battle in the One Super Series Muay Thai contest. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. The ONE Super Series Muay Thai contest got the crowd on their feet in the co-main event of ONE Pursuit of Power. Two-division Lion Fight World Champion Joe Nadawat showed off his firepower against Super Muay Thai World Champion Johan Dre.
It's a ONE Super Series featherweight Muay Thai contest. Set for three rounds of action between Smoke and Joe Nadawat and Johan Fairtex Dre.
Ready, go!
Referee Atsushi Onari gets us underway. The fluorescent trunks on Dre, the red and gold on Nadawat. This one brought to you by United International Pictures, Mission Impossible Fallout in cinemas July. Body shot nicely done off the lead hand from Smoking Joe. Then goes to the outside thigh. Checks the inside leg kick. Jab two from Smoking Joe. Knees are permitted. Elbows are permitted. Front kick there from Joe. Highlights roundhouse kick. Roundhouse kick again off the lead leg from Joe and a nice high check. Front kick from Dre. Overhand right from Smoke and Joe, he tags him! Here comes the monster truck! Here comes the punishment! Joe with the heavy artillery!
Now good job by Dre to keep his wits about him when the onslaught was coming down.
Look at these knees from Joe, not about the trajectory! The point of the knee driving into the outside left thigh of Dre. Smoke and Joe, house on fire here in the first round. The uppercut, the elbows, the high kicks.
Michael, you said you wanted to see the Smoke and Joe from Lion Fight, and this is the Smoke and Joe.
Smoke and Joe Nadawat opening up on Johan Dre in the first round. There's the right hand. Dre's on rubber legs. Smoke and Joe unloading. The elbows now. The high left roundhouse. The body shot to the liver. Dre in a whole lot of bother. The right hand, a big kabosh. Down goes Dre. He's doing the chicken dance. And referee Onari puts a standing count on. Dre's okay to go on. Joe pounces on him again. High left roundhouse kick, trying for the headache maker. Joe with the overhand right. Uppercut from Joe. There's the left hand. Smoke and Joe goes to the body. The power, the precision of the Muay Thai monster truck.
Wow, with those small gloves, it is just slicing through the guard of Dre. You can see Johan Dre trying to cover up like he's covered up with big gloves, but there's so little room to get through.
Overhand right from Smoke and Joe. Ties him up, there's the elbow to the orbital. Uppercut elbow and a beautiful Muay Thai dump there from Smoke and Joe Nadawat.
That was a beautiful redirection there. Came around and just sat Johan Dre down.
Left hand and a right. Johan Dre, how is he still standing? That's good night, Irene. No, yes, it's over. Smoke and Joe, Smoke and Joe, Smoke and Joe. That's the Joe Nadawat who became famous in America. That's the Joe Nadawat who became a two-division champ.
Wow. I got to see the time on that, because that could have been at the very last second of the first round.
That could be your go, Daddy, knockout of the night.
Wow, the punches came in bunches, and Smoking Joe was able to score another knockout.
That is the ferocity that Smoking Joe Nadawat is renowned for.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 59 seconds in the first round, here is your winner by way of knockout, Joe Nadawat!
That is the Joe Nadawat we've come to know over recent years. That's why we call him the Muay Thai monster truck, because he demolishes and runs over opponents with aggressive Muay Thai like we just saw. The winner's medal goes back to Atlanta, Georgia.
When we return, undefeated American Tyler Maguire go head-to-head with Brazilian veteran Luis Santos. You're watching One Championship Weekly. Welcome back to One Championship Weekly. Tyler Maguire made a huge impression on his ONE debut when he took on Brazilian veteran Luis Santos. The American relied on his ground game and frequently dragged the bout to the canvas, where he enjoyed prolonged periods of stifling top control. We pick up the action in round three.
Will we see Sabo Santos raise the aggressor meter here in the third and final round? Has he been playing possum at all? A jumping front kick there from Sabo.
Neck was a little bit low.
If we can change, just stopping the action here.
Ready, go!
Back underway here in the third and final. They touch gloves. Maguire moving a lot now. Circling into that non-power side of Sapo Santos. Got to stay away from Santos's left leg. Santos, can he put the foot down now? Can he press the turbo in the final round? There's the high kick from Sapo. Now we may start to see the heavy artillery come flying from the veteran.
I see him go back to that leg kick. He went low, then he went high, go back low again and attack that lower leg. Stop the movement of Maguire. Get him stationary so we can unload.
Jumping roundhouse from Sabo. Jumping front kick from the Taekwondo stylist and a spinning hook kick. We're going to use the cage again there. Tyler Maguire putting on a show here in Kuala Lumpur. On his ONE Championship debut, the 10-0 undefeated American.
Looks like he's calling for an eye poke.
I don't see it, Mitch. I see a palm heel.
It looked like a palm, but then he did take his hand away, and the eyes are very delicate.
Ready, go!
Mitch, you may have had it correct, though, when you said Santos maybe took a timeout to recollect himself, recompose himself. He's a wily veteran. He knows all the tricks.
This is true, Michael Cervello.
Still underway here in the third and final round. Fake there from Sapo. Lines up the left roundhouse kick. Outside leg kick from Maguire. Hands still low, but Sapo has not capitalized on that. He tries to now.
See, now he's got a little bit more pep. You know, he utilized his break very effectively, and now he realizes that he's down a bit and he's letting these feet go.
Maguire didn't want the kick, so he drives him off the cage. Gets a takedown. Top position now for the American. Okay, what are the options for Tyler Maguire here, Dragon?
Tyler Maguire is very comfortable in half guard. I don't really expect him to try to do anything different, but he's got both legs laced underneath him, and he tries to step over. Oh, look at that. Beautifully steps over into side control, and now he's got that gable grip there, and he lets it go. Now he's going after the head. Heavy top pressure coming from Maguire as he starts soften Sapo up with those elbows.
Side control position here for Tyler Maguire. Third round, somewhere Maguire hasn't been for quite a while. He does have two decision victories on his record. Also 8 first round knockouts. He had predicted a second round finish of Sapo. And look at these elbows, reverse elbows to the side of the head. Dominant side control from the American. Sapo needs to find some way to turn the tide here, Dragon.
He does. Otherwise, Maguire might continue this role. And we have another very interesting welterweight matchup coming up in the main event. And maybe there might be a tangle in the future. Look at Maguire, just so heavy. He's able to control a BJJ and judo black belt very impressively and just having his way with him right now.
Still inside control. The reverse elbows, Sapo with no place to go. What tricks does the veteran have left up his sleeve here? He's got to find something. He's got to dig deep now, Sabo. Get off of his back. Get back to the feet and try and inflict some punishment with under 80 seconds remaining.
He might just want to turn to the wrong side that way. There you go. Keeps going that way. Belly down. Try to create a scramble if he's got the juice left for it. Gasapo is never out of these. He can still snatch up submissions. If he can get back up, he's still got that power.
Mitch, this is an impressive, challenging debut for Ty McGuire.
Very impressive to do this to a 76-match veteran. To just dominate and control a competitor like Sabo in these rounds. Oh, but look at Sabo!
And now he's up the chance. 40 seconds remaining. Can Sabo get off the strikes now? Sabo's hands up high. Let's see if he slings the legs. McGuire constantly moving, changing angles. Sabo resets. Under 30 seconds to go now. Sabo's gonna go. He's gonna put the foot down. He's gonna go now.
I'm expecting some wild kicks in the last 20 seconds here.
Sabo needs to close off the movement of McGuire. Back elbow, spinning back fist from Sabo. McGuire dancing and grooving and moving around the one championship cage. He smells a victory. He smells a decision. Sabo comes forward. Hands are down. Sabo doesn't throw. And a great debut in one championship from Tyler McGuire.
Man, this is what we were talking about. You know, Sabo trying to go for the sweep, utilizes the half guard, scrambles to the other side. You can never count Sabo out. Continually trying to attack, but just, I think, overwhelmed by the undefeated American.
After three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. From the blue corner, Tyler McGuire.
Tyler McGuire continues his undefeated record. It goes 11-0, 1-0 now in one championship. Tyler McGuire takes the winner's medal.
World-class martial arts action returns to Manila, Philippines next with One Reign of Kings. The headlining bout promises to deliver fireworks as Filipino hero Kevin Belingon takes on two Division I world champion Martin Nguyen in the One Interim Bantamweight World Championship. Nguyen is in the hunt for a third division title and will make history if he succeeds in Manila.
This third belt, it means everything to me. It's all about building my legacy and leaving my mark on this division, this organization, and world history. I'll be the first three-divisional world champion and consecutively defend each division.
Oh, jumping knee!
He's got the hands clasped. Beautiful transition.
High knee from Martin Nguyen.
I've learned so much about myself. Most importantly, to always trust in my skills, to be able to push a five-time Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu world champion to his limit. How much of an athlete I've become. Coming off that first split decision loss off at the start of the year, it's only motivated me to come back even stronger. It's only an honor to go up against someone like Kevin, so this bout's gonna be an explosive one.
Standing in Nguyen's way for the bantamweight belt is Kevin Belingon and his world-class striking. Here's the Team Lakai star demonstrating his explosive knockout power against Andrew Leone.
Ready? Ready?
Go! A touch gloves, second round set for three. It is scored as an overall contest, but no doubt it's one that Belingon is clearly leading at the moment. But what happens? That sense of intrigue if Leone can put Belingon on his back. Hasn't happened yet. Belingon scoring two takedowns in the opening round or two times, putting Leone on his back. Leone circling counterclockwise.
That's good. He's got to stay away from circling to that wrong side. If he keeps circling right, keeps moving to Belingon's left side, that's going to avoid that big right hand.
Belingon pivoting, center ring, doesn't want to give it up here. I
again. Belingon like a ticking time bomb. Could explode at any moment. Oh, Tony back kick drops him! Tony back kick drops him! Tony back kick drops him! Here comes Belingon! Manila in a meltdown! That was awesome! A turning back kick to the liver, dropped Andrew Leone. And now the aggression, the ground and pound, the unloading, the assault, the barrage, the goodnight Irene!
Beautiful display shown by Kevin Belingon, a beautiful spinning sidekick. And then the punches rain down like a Filipino typhoon as he just started dropping him, and he forced this referee to jump in and save him. Absolutely tremendous victory.
Your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 27 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Kevin Belingon!
Kevin Belingon sends a message to Bibiano Fernandez, the champion. He sends an aggressive message with a huge exclamation mark. The most impressive, the most dominant, the most ruthless performance of Belingon's career. Brought the house down completely in Manila. They went into a frenzy.
On the 27th of July, ONE Championship heads to Manila, Philippines to stage one of the biggest martial arts events of 2018. In an epic main event, two Division I World Champion Martin Nguyen attempts to capture a historic third belt, the ONE Interim Bantamweight World Championship, against Filipino hero Kevin Belingon. In the co-main event, martial arts legend Shinya Aoki takes on Thai superstar Shannon Wirichai. BJJ master Henzo Gracie clashes with Yuki Kondo in a legend versus legend bout. And Filipino star Edward Falayong battles with Aziz Perudinov from Russia. Check your local listings. You've been watching ONE Championship Weekly. Press the red button to subscribe.